Hello friends, welcome back. My name is PK. In this video, you will learn how to create a beautiful 3D chart for weekly sales. I have created this 3D stack chart for country-wise sales, and here we have taken the country US, UK and India, and we have taken the day of week as Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday and Saturday. So friends, if you will see, we have given a gap between each stack, so we can change the gap number also. As of now it is 20. You can change this number, let's say 30, then you can see the gap is getting changed. So I have taken here the random number, you can put your original number. If I will keep the gap at 0, then you can see there is no gap in the stack column. Okay, so you can keep the gap as per your requirement. So I have taken 10, 20 or let's say 50, then you can see a big gap. The number for the gap you can take according to the sales, because I have taken the sales between 50 to 90, so I'm taking the gap around 20 or 25 so that it will be visible properly. If your number is in thousand or millions, accordingly you can change the number of gap. Now I will explain you how we can create this in Microsoft Excel. So let's start without delay. Let me add a new worksheet here and I'll show you how can you create. Let's say we have some day wise data. So here we have day and I have the day from Sunday till Saturday, and here I have, let's say, US, UK and India. We can take some random number here, so let's use the randbetween function and let's take our term 50, and I have taken 50 to 90. You can take your original number here. Let's copy this number in this range. Alright. Now we will insert a support row after each item. So what I will do, I'll insert here another row and I'll keep the name as gap. Okay. So here you can make it dynamic. So let's put here gap, and let's say here I'm putting 20. You can put the formula, this value equal to this one. And let's freeze this, so press F4 to freeze this and just hit the enter. Copy this and paste here. Now I will copy this entire row and I'll select this Tuesday, right click and go to the insert copied cell. So this is available here, and similarly we can copy and insert the copied cells once again here. Alright, so here you can see we have Sunday, then we have this gap, then we have Monday, again we have gap. After each day we have this gap value, and this gap value is just simply the value of this H1. So if I will change the value here, let's say 30, then you can see everywhere, wherever we have taken the gap is 30 now. Alright friends, now I will select this data, then I will go to the insert and I will go to the insert column or bar chart. And here I will take the 3D column chart and I will take this 3D stack column chart. So this chart is available with us. You can see it will look like this. Now just select this chart and go to the chart design, and here we have this switch row column option, or you can right click, go to the select data, and here we have this switch row column. Just click on this, click on OK. So our chart will look like this. Alright. Now what we can do, first of all let's uncheck the chart title, grid lines from here, and even we can remove the legend from here. From the axis we can remove the vertical axis, so just select and delete. Alright, so we have these three bars with this tag. So the first one, if I will click here, then you can see the Saturday is selected. Go to the next one. This is for the gap. You can see in the data, so this gap is selected. Now go to the format and say fill and say no fill. Now I will click on the next one. This is Friday. We can see I'll click the next one, which is gap. So for all gap, go to the say fill and say no fill. Similarly, this one is the gap, no fill, and this one is also gap. Alright, for all gaps we have put the no fill. Just select this Saturday and then I'll go to the save fill and let's change the color. So I'm taking this orange accent 2, and then I'll go to the save effects bevel and I'll take this bevel round. Alright, so it will look like this. Then I will select the next. This is for the gap, so we will not select the gap. We'll go to the next. This is for the Friday. Here we will take another color. So let's say I am taking this blue. Then weevil, I'll take here same weevil which is round. Now select the next one. This is for Thursday. And this time I will take the another color. You can choose the color as per your requirement, but here I am taking these colors and take the round weevil. Similarly for the next day. Now you can right click on any of the bar, go to the format data series, and here you can change the gap width. So let's take around this gap width. For the X rotation, let's keep around 30 or 40. Alright. Now we will make the changes in the axis. So just go to the home, take the black color, make it bold, slightly bigger, so that it will be visible properly. And you can take the font as Arial Rounded Empty Bold. Just remove the bold from here. If you will see, the name of the country is not properly aligned with the bars. So what we can do, we can insert, just insert and insert shift cells down. Okay, so you can copy this header and just keep it here. What I will do, I'll use multiple space before the country name, so that it will be aligned properly. So what I will do, I'll use here a rep function, and I'll take the text as single space, then number of times. So I would like to take, let's say 20 times, and then I will use and I'll take this country name. Just hit the enter. Okay. So now just copy this and paste it here. All right. So let's make it slightly smaller. Okay, so it is aligned now properly. Okay, now we will add the data label. So just select first one, right click, go to the add data label. Now select the data label, go to the format data labels, and here we will show the series name also. So we have the values and the series name. So just make it white font bold. Similarly, select the next one, right click, add data label. Select the data label, right click, go to the format data label, and here just add the series value also. Make it white and bold. Now select this green one, right click, add data label. So we will repeat the same activity, right click, go to the format data label, add the series name here. Make it white and bold. Alright, so we have added the data label and the series name here, so it is looking good. Now you can add the chart title also, and you can keep the chart title, let's say weekly sale, or whatever you want to keep. Alright, you can change the size of the plot area. Okay friends, now we can hide these gaps from here. So select this, this and this. Using the control key, we are selecting multiple rows. And we will hide this row also, and just press Control 9 to hide the multiple rows. So we have hide multiple rows. So you can see the chart is also not looking proper because no gap is visible. So what we can do, we can right click on the chart, go to the select data, and here we will go to the hidden and empty cell, and we will check this show data in hidden rows and columns. Just click on OK. Okay, so it is visible properly. If I will change the gap value, let's say 10, then you can see gap is reduced. If I will put the gap value as, let's say 60, then you can see gap is properly visible now. So you can keep your gap value, whatever you want to keep. Alright friends. Friends, I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please hit the like button and please subscribe my channel to get the regular update of my videos. Thank you so much for watching.